You know, as long as the sun rises, I'm going to be up. Because my father is the light. And I have a right to everything that he has created that is good. I have a right to everything that he has created that is good, my brothers and my sisters. And you have that right also. That's why I get up early. And I thank my father for allowing me to arrive up early. There was a time prior that I used to wonder who my father was. But there are no times now that I wonder who my father is. So I get up and I do that I got to do. And I know to maintain maintenance of my mind, my brothers and my sisters. For elements can arrive within our atmosphere and cause creates effect, and we begin to become wet from the elements that have arrived within our atmosphere. But we never checked out the makeup of our mind, and we did not know that those elements were in the forecast. That's why, my brothers and my sisters, we must always maintain maintenance of our mind as we go along in time. God has always told us to renew our mind. The Bible speaks about renewing our mind, renewing our mind, renewing our mind, renewing our mind. We must always renew our mind, my brothers and my sisters. We must be careful of what we feed on, what type of pictures on TV that there are creating pictures within our mentality. What type of information in books are creating information within our mentality? What conversation coming out of our mouth that's creating a transformation within our mentality, my brothers and my sisters? We always say we are not at fault, because the spirits that are within us are at fault. But we are to blame, because we're going to be held accountable for what we do. But there are many forces, as I said, that are out there that have gotten in here. One force may be smoking, as I said, cigarettes. Another force may be sex. Another force may be drinking. Another force may be robbery. You may have many forces within you that are forcing you to do the things that you do. But but you're the one that's going to be blamed. You're the one that's going to be blamed, my brothers and my sisters, because they're working through your vehicle in order to introduce what they want to introduce into the atmosphere. I like to read to you from 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 33, where it says, "For God is not the author of confusion." So if God is not the author of confusion, why should we have to walk around confused when we don't have to walk around confused, my brothers and my sisters? We do not have to walk around confused. I like to read to you from 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7, where it says, "For God has given us the spirit, but God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind." So if we are to have a sound mind, my brothers and my sisters, the only way we can have a sound mind is have the right elements in our atmosphere. The only way that we can maintain maintenance of our mind, we must check out what's in our mind that we have to maintain. My brothers and my sisters, because there are things that arrive unto us that we don't know that are there. You know, I was asked to sit in on a session, counseling meeting of individuals, and I won't speak on names, but I'll just speak on situations where the psychiatrists are talking to the individuals. And see, I know how that works, because usually the problem arrives back to childhood. But what they don't understand, the psychiatrist, is that the problem arrives, yes, to childhood. And you can go from childhood up to teenhood, up to adulthood, and maybe diagnose the situation of the individual that you're diagnosing. But in order to go back before the individual that you're diagnosing had the problem, maybe their mother had the problem. Maybe their grandmother had the problem. Maybe their mother and their mother and their mother and their mother and their grandmother had the problem. So you're talking about a psychological problem that arrived through the generations, where somebody might have been abused, and then that somebody that might have been abused somebody else because they was abused, and that somebody that might have been abused somebody else till they was abused. And the cycle continued on down into now. But to get to the source of the problem, it would not be a psychological problem. It would be a spiritual problem. Because the source of the problem is the spirits that occupy the body that's creating the problem. The spirits that are occupying the body that's creating the problem. Because it's the forces within the physical body that's creating the problem to the person. That's creating the problem's mentality to be made up to that it's becoming made up to be. That's the source of the problem. But we have those in the professional field that don't deal with the spirit. They deal with the mentality. And since they don't deal with the spirit, but they deal with the mentality, then they never arrive to the source of the problem. So they never can really have a solution to the problem. Because sometimes you might need an exorcism. Somebody may need to get demonic forces somehow taken out of them. Because they arrive within us, brothers and sisters, many of them. And we never look at them because we can't see them, as I say, but they see us. And we don't think of it as being them that's creating our problem. We think that we are creating our own problem. But when you look to find out that mama had the problem and grandma had the problem and grandma's grandma had the problem and so on and so forth, so you got to think it's either generational curses that's been passed on, or different forces and dark forces that are entering from generation to generation, my brothers and my sisters. So we need to be very careful. I think it's good to go to doctors and have them figure out, if they can figure out what's wrong with you. You might need medication, it could be many different factors and creating many different problems that's in many different individuals, my brothers and my sisters. But the point I'm speaking on is, if you maintain maintenance of your mind, it can help you when you don't add to your problem by commenting, by cursing, by drinking, by smoking. If you can help yourself by not doing them things, if you can't help yourself, then get somebody who can help you to where you won't do them things, my brothers and my sisters, because you can have, as I said, a good job, because I know a lot, but Dr. Jekylls and Mr. Hyde, but it is not my job to speak on that, because it's just not my job. But you have a lot of people that have a lot of problems, brothers and sisters, and they cover it up. I mean, they will tell you not to drink, and they go home and they're drinking like fish, and they're professional people. But I'm saying that to say this: you just don't know who may have the problem, but everyone's trying to help somebody. But you need to see what you need to do in order to get help. My brothers and my sisters here, there's a lot out there. I'd like to read you from James chapter 1, verse 5, where it says, if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all liberally and without reproach, and it will be given to him. Wisdom is the thing that we all need, my brothers and my sisters. But I speak to you from my heart. I have a mind, and I know that, like I tell you, the mind is just space, as I say. What comes into mind is what I speak out of my mentality. But because I maintain maintenance of my mind, there are certain forms of information I'm not going to be allowed to be made up within my mentality, because there's certain forces that's trying to bring me sources of information, and I will not allow those forces to bring the source of information that they would like to put in my head. And I maintain maintenance continuously, daily, because that's what I do in order to have sanity, in order to have peace of mind, my brothers and my sisters. It is good to read your Bible. It is good, my brothers and sisters. We need to help each other. Whatever we got that is good that we can help each other with, we need to give it to each other. We need to give it to each other. Amen.